Hello everyone, so hello to welcome to another Fabric Mod Review, this time on Gubbins, a mod that simply adds a ton of different things, such as different blocks, a few ores, a telescope, some boats, mostly a bunch of decorative and other stuff. So I'll just cover the sort of spoilers here first, since I do have quite a few mods installed and some things might be a bit different, so just in case if the world gen or otherwise is very particular, so you can see in the spoilers how they are probably supposed to look, or which ones are from the mod. You can see some hardened dirt among normal but dirt here, in some cave-like biomes. You've got prismarine among stone, you've got overgrown areas in mine shafts, some leaves and grass blocks, so you've got adornments which you can apply to chest plates and helmets. So, which I haven't come across the block for yet. We've got ice caves, which is where you'll get also some ice ore of the vanilla ore variations. There's also additional ones that appear in oceans, the nether, and end. Campfires can be dyed, and there's also a bunch of decoration blocks that obviously you find in different biomes or can craft yourself. And there's also a bunch of other things that we'll be covering. So, obviously a few things there that I didn't really notice yet, because obviously I focus usually on items and blocks first. But we'll start with those, such as the snow bricks, which is just snow blocks, like so, or in a stone cutter. You've got some mossy stone, which is stone and vines, not cobblestone and vines. You would typically get with mostly cobblestone. You have hardened dirt, which is a 2x2 of dirt, like so, or found underground, most likely, if what it is reflects. You've got hardened dirt being used to make hardened dirt bricks, and can also be made in a stone cutter. You've got basalt bricks, which is obviously basalt in 116. You can do that in a stone cutter as well. There's also a polished version, which is just itself apparently, or more accessible in a stone cutter with basalt, polished, and so forth. Actually, no, polished itself, which I haven't covered yet. No? Okay, so maybe it is itself. Okay. Other than that, we have snow brick slabs, again, made with a stone cutter, or like so. Walls and stairs, so you can get an idea of how much you gain per crafting or the stone cutter. Mossy stone slabs, walls and stairs. And there's also the other variations of those. And there's also brick variations as well. Also have basalt bricks, which are made like so, and pretty much the same sort of outcomes of recipes there. So, besides the world gen for the decorative side, we do obviously have the ores like so, which I will just get a few of just in case to demo what sort of pickaxes you need to harvest these. So just cycle through each. So, let's see, nothing there. I'm assuming we need iron or diamond for any of these. Yep, so nothing there. Okay, so there's no breaking animation slots. So you can break those, no problem, with an iron pickaxe or higher, it seems. When you have these, though, you can use them for a block, and that seems to be pretty much it at the moment. Don't know if they'll have much more, but for the most part, they are just for that. We'll show the world gem afterwards. We have a potion flask, which can be made like so. I'm assuming you can make possibly typical potions, but you will most likely have other benefits as well. So just try some water if I can find any, which I can't. So I'll get a 2x2 water and see if we can fill this up. Or if it's just using other potions, possibly, rather than just being a larger scale one. So we can't do anything there. No potion effects, there's nothing else at all about it. But my guess is it's going to be a larger version of regular potions, and it'll store maybe 3 or 5 lots that you can consume, rather than just having to have however many, and they take up how much space in your inventory. That's my guess of the purpose of it. But until we see that, I don't know. I've got the quiver, which is made with leather and string. If we right-click this, you can see it stores arrows. So if we just do this, store the following stacks. We'll just sort of move this out of the way. You'll see it'll take some from the quiver. No problem. I don't know if you could use this with trinkets, but possibly. Continue with arrows, we do have the following. We'll just get some more arrows, like so. And we'll see how much this does, so, or what it does in particular. So, possibly, I don't think too much damage there, but maybe I think I'm supposed to give some type of water, underwater type of thing? Rather than just maybe using flint, it's possibly more damage, or possibly useful to shoot underwater, which we'll actually try. So if we just say put ourselves underwater, can we actually fire these underwater without the other being awkward? Because I'm pretty sure arrows themselves do have gravity differences as well. Whilst these ones probably don't. I should go to a lake biome properly here, if I can find one, or a pond of sorts. Here we go, got a river. We'll just test these out underwater. So, regular arrows, not the best. Just I'm assuming prismarine arrows, more useful underwater, so you can fire them and you don't have the awkwardness of gravity, I guess, underwater. Something like that. But, yeah. So, probably the same damage, but just useful in underwater circumstances when fighting off certain mobs. Other than that, however, we do have the sort of display item stuff, which I'm assuming is possibly just armor or something to do with like an armor stand later or something. But other than that, not sure. We'll probably get more in the future. And this is to do with the actual armor here that we have, which is the adornments, which we don't have the table for, I think, just yet. At least I can't see it. Unless it is the smithing table, and I just can't tell because I'm in night mode. That also might be the case. Yes, it will. Okay, so that's probably why. So the smithing fletching is eventually used for this, it seems. Let's get a helmet, such as a netherite, and we wanted gold, it seems. I'm assuming this is maybe just to add a bit more to them. Yes, okay, so if we wanted to try others and see what's available as adornments. We try that. We want this, and we'll try something like cobble and leather as well, and see if those can also be applied to some of these. So we'll just get, say, I don't know, diamond armor for example, and see what we get. So leather, no go. Cobble, no go. Iron is possible. Diamond on diamond, obviously not possible. We'll try, let's see, some gold armor for example, say some leggings, and we can. So I'm assuming you can't use it if it's the same resource, no. So obviously you can't do that. I don't think you can, no, you can't switch them out either. If you don't want iron anymore, you're kind of stuck with it. So, yeah. And I don't think uncrafting will work. So if you wanted adornments, we can do that, or possibly similar to the leather armor, where you've got sort of the different patches there. It's now sort of filling in bits and pieces on those, but on the other types of armor, with the sort of kneecaps and other aspects of the armor are. quite interesting. Finally, however, we have the telescope, which obviously if you hold down right click by default, you'll be obviously able to sort of zoom in and see a bit further distances, but it does have durability, however, even in creative mode. The telescope doesn't have a recipe, it seems, so can't do much with that. But if you want to see further distances, or sort of isolate the area that you're focusing on, you can obviously do that. Otherwise, we do have the boats, which you can make with the crimson or warped woods, but if you place it in the world, it will crash the game. So I just put in a warped one, because I've already tried a crimson, and both of them crash the game. So be careful of those in this current version that I'm using here, which is 1.0.1. And and I have reported it, so it will be covered eventually, or patched out, hopefully, over time. Thanks so much for watching, and goodbye.